Okay, so now let me go ahead and do my last elasticity application here with the help of my good friend Luke Skywalker, Lego Luke Skywalker. So, suppose we know that elasticity equals -3/4. We cut prices by 8%. How does that impact our total revenue? So remember that total revenue, sometimes just called revenue, revenue is how much money you take in, your total dollar sales volume before any costs. So total revenue is just price times quantity. And I'm going to go ahead and use a numerical example method here. This is not going to be a general proof, but it will give you a way to solve the problem that's probably easier for most students than a more general algebraic version of this. So I'm going to go ahead and suppose that my initial P1 is a nice round $100, and my initial Q1 is a nice round 100 units. So my initial total revenue 1 is $100 times 100 units, and that gets me to $10,000 of initial total revenue there. So first thing we're going to do after all that is going to be, we're going to ask ourselves, what is our percent change in quantity? Well, we know that elasticity equals percent change in quantity demanded over percent change in price. We know our elasticity number here is -3/4. So -3/4 goes over there. And our percent change in price is what? Now this one will trick you. It's 8%, but it's a price cut. So it's -8%. So we have -8% here on the bottom. And we have percent change in quantity demanded, our unknown, still remaining on the top. So we're going to go ahead and multiply both sides by -8%. That cancels this one out. And -8% times -3/4, the two negative signs cancel out to make a positive. And 8 times 3/4, or 8% times 3/4, is 6%. So we have a positive 6% change in quantity demanded. Our number of units sold grows by 6%. So if we originally had a price of P1 of $100 and we cut our prices by 8%, then our new price is 8% lower, or $92. And you can go back and actually apply the percentage change problem formula formally if you want. But the nice way that I picked these numbers here makes it easy to see what the new level of P2 would be. Q2, well, if we initially sold 100 units and now we're selling 6% more, then we're now selling 106 units. So total revenue 2 is going to be $92 times 106 units. So, not something I can do in my head, but my notes tell me that that is 9,742. And when we compare that versus our previous $10,000 revenue, we could go ahead and do a percentage change based on that. And our percent change in total revenue is going to be total revenue 2 minus total revenue 1 over total revenue 1 times 100. And that's going to go ahead and be 9752 minus 10,000 over 10,000 times 100. And I believe the answer here is negative 2.48%. So that's our overall impact on revenue. And does this make sense? Well, we cut our prices by 8% and we sold 6% more. And just at the intuitive level, if I'm getting 8% less money for each unit, and I'm only selling 6% more units, then from a total revenue point of view, I'm worse off. So that checks out with the fact that we have a negative percentage change here. And that's my last example.